Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. And if you hear any voice or noises in this video, please ignore, because I have a lot of we have some repair work going on. So anything you can imagine that should not be there at your place when you're filming, including drills and hammers, it's all there. So that's what's making the noise. But I really wanted to put this video up because so many of you had been requesting it, and I did promise that I will be putting it up soon. So this is a review of the Nykaa Skin Genius foundation that recently launched, and I haven't tried it, so it's going to be a first impression. It's the Nykaa Skin Genius Sculpting and Hydrating Foundation, and there are a lot of claims on this foundation, so I'm just going to read them to you before we start. Weightless texture meets luxurious long wear formula with Nykaa Skin Genius foundation. It seamlessly melts in your skin and hydrates your skin with its PolyLift technology and hyaluronic acid. The color stays true always, and the sun filters shield your perfected complexion all day long. So basically, it has hyaluronic acid, which is supposed to be very it's supposed to give you a very radiant finish because it absorbs the moisture from the surroundings, and it stays and gives that moisture to your skin. So this is what the tube looks like, and actually it's pretty tiny. I mean, when I watched reviews of other people, it looked like a bigger tube, but it's pretty tiny. But it still has a 30 ml of product, which is a standard foundation quantity that you get. So the interesting thing about this foundation that has everybody going bonkers is that it adapts to your skin tone, apparently. I don't know, because I haven't tried it on my face yet. So when you shop online for foundations and concealers and stuff like that, it's very easy to go wrong with the shade. So they say that you can buy a shade darker or a shade lighter because it will adapt to your skin tone. So I got the shade third, which is warm sand, and I don't know if it's gonna suit me or not, but apparently it will adjust to my skin tone, so we'll see how that goes. And I'm gonna be buffing that in on my face using the Real Techniques Expert Face Brush. Actually, I'm gonna take it directly on my finger and dot it all over my face. This looks like a pretty good match, I would say. I mean, it's not really like bad or anything. I mean, it's still workable. We'll see how that goes. Right off the bat, I can say that it does not have a lot of coverage. I would say it's like sheer to medium. It is not like a coverage providing foundation in any way. I think they targeted it as being like an everyday foundation for the average woman, because I mean, I don't know. I think that's what it is. It's just a theory, so don't hold me on that. Okay, the first thing that I'm noticing is that it's very, very dewy, and that is an issue for me because, as you guys would know by now, I am extremely oily. So I don't know how it's gonna last if I don't set this, and even if I set this, I don't know how it's gonna like wear throughout the day, because initially also it looks very dewy. I really, really hope that it sets, because if it doesn't, we're gonna have a problem. Thank you. Yeah, it's getting a little better. I think it just takes a little time to set, and I think it's finally starting to settle down a bit. It feels, yeah, it's starting to feel quite tacky, and foundations do that when they start to set. So I've had this foundation on my skin for about 10 to 15 minutes now, and I think this is how it sets. It looks really dewy, and it is also quite tacky, and you do get a little transfer. Like when I do this, my skin is sticking to my fingers and a little product comes off when you do that. So I won't be okay with leaving my house as this is. So I will definitely set it. So to set it, I'm gonna use my Lakme 9to5 Flawless Matte Complexion Compact in the shade Melon. Yeah, that's looking a lot better actually. And now my face looks really, really flat, and I don't like that look, so I'm gonna contour. And to contour, I'm gonna use my Revolution Ultra Pro HD Powder Contour Kit in the shade Medium Dark. And to contour, I'm gonna use my face's blush brush. It's angled, so I think it works really good for contouring. I don't take my contour into my mouth. I've seen a lot of people use the ear to tip of the mouth method, and it might work for you, but it doesn't work for me, because when I look down like that, the hollows of my cheeks go down like this, and I've never seen anybody's hollows of their like cheeks going into their mouth, and I just feel that it actually makes your cheeks look a lot chubbier. So if you have to contour, I suggest going like this and then bringing it down like that. I'm gonna use the NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream in the shade Room. And I'm actually gonna include this in my nudes video. That sounds really bad. I meant the video that I'm gonna make for including all my favorite nude lipsticks. So guys, in conclusion, I would like to say that I do think this foundation is really, really good, and particularly for those people who have a normal to dry skin, because it will give you a lot of hydration throughout the day. And I've had this foundation on my skin for about 20 to 25 minutes now, and it does look a lot better than it did initially, because now I think it has adapted to my skin tone apparently. And it does look a lot better. And if you are oily, I would suggest that you set it with a powder and touch up anytime you want to when your skin starts looking oily, and carry those oil blotting sheets. And setting it with a powder still will not completely mattify it, because the natural radiance that this foundation has will shine through it, and it doesn't look oily or bad in any way. Like right now, I don't know how it's gonna wear throughout the day, but like first impressions, really, I think I really like this foundation. And if I have I'm sorry, I just can't stop looking at my skin, because my skin looks like skin for once, because foundations don't really look good on me, and I'm just so weirded out by the fact that this one does. So one thing that I do want to mention that might not be too good for some people is that this foundation does contain silicon, and if you are allergic to silicon, I will not recommend this to you, because it does say right here in the ingredients that this has trimethylsiloxysilicate and it has dimethicone. And I don't know about the other one, but dimethicone is a form of silicon. So if you are allergic to silicon, you might not like this. Yeah. Other than that, I really like it. It's priced really nicely, which is amazing, because I haven't heard of any other foundation that does this color flip thing at this price. I mean, I have heard of foundations that will adapt to your skin over time, but this is priced at $575. The packaging is really good, and you have 5 shades, and I'm not mad at them because they launched 5 shades, because I hate it when brands come out with like 5 shades or 10 shades and like foundations or concealers, because that to me is ridiculous, because I don't think people can fit into 10 shades, you know, if you know what I mean. I mean, if you're launching a foundation or concealer or anything like that, you need to have at least 20 to 25 shades. You can cater to everyone, but because this foundation adapts to your skin tone, I think starting with 5 shades is okay. And I do hope though that they come out with more shades, probably towards the darker side, because there weren't many dark shades, there were just 2, and they still looked pretty light to me. So far so good, and I really like this foundation. And if you're someone who's looking to get into a medium priced foundation which will look good on you, give you a radiant dewy finish and something you can wear on a daily basis, I think you should try this. And that is it for this video, guys. Thank you so much for tuning into my channel today. Please subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.